Hi, I'm Dylan with MasterCam. With the launch of MasterCam 2021, MultiAxis Roughing has now become MultiAxis Pocketing. Let's take a look at the new functionality that this brings and how we can use it to drive our accelerated finishing tools in unique ways. As the name change implies, MultiAxis Pocketing comes with some new abilities. We can now finish both wall and floor surfaces in addition to roughing material. Here, we'll utilize a new approach to wall finishing in MultiAxis Pocketing to go over some of these improvements. We want to finish the tan walls of the pocket on this mold part. The walls have a slight draft, and the location and depth of the pocket isn't ideal for a swarf toolpath. This is a perfect candidate for an oval form accelerated finishing tool. This will let us use a large step over to replace a ball mill and take some time out of the finishing path. One of the traditional challenges with accelerated finishing tools is how to handle the intersection of wall and floor surfaces to clean up as much material as possible. Let's take a step back and look at a familiar multi-axis parallel path that finishes these walls. We're maintaining an 80-degree angle tilt to get the contact patch we want on this oval form tool. With the shape of the tool, this means that we'll violate the floor surfaces before we're able to clean down to the sharp inner corner of the pocket. To cope with this, we could implement several different strategies to manage how the tool reacts to the floor surface. A gradual tilt change value would allow MasterCam to slowly shift the contact point to the ball nose of the tool by the time it reaches the floor. Alternately, we could implement a collision control strategy to change the tilt of the tool when it contacts the floor. Both methods are valid and produce a good toolpath, but they can require some initial programming time to set up. In the case of a gradual tilt value, we would have to start over again if we switched to a different tool shape. Additionally, the linking parameters, pass lead-ins and lead-outs, and the gap sizes all have to be adjusted by the programmer to get the final motion we see here. Now, we'll tackle these same surfaces with multi-axis pocketing. In the cut pattern page, I'll change the machining pattern to wall finishing and use a parallel strategy. For a guide curve to stay parallel to, I'll use the floor curve. I'll add wall surfaces and shift-click to select the entire pocket perimeter wall at once. I'll add the floor surface in and then move on to tool axis control. Tool axis control for multi-axis pocketing is very different from other multi-axis paths. Rather than drive the tool via the side tilt angle, we're defining a minimum, maximum, and preferred contact point along the cutting flutes of the tool. Whenever possible, the path will drive the tool at the preferred contact point and vary the tool tilt as necessary to maintain this point. We'll change this minimum contact point to 5%. This means that as the tool comes down to the floor area, we're allowing it to deviate from the preferred contact point to come down towards the tip in order to get closer to the floor surface. For linking, I'll leave clearance blend spline on and I'll click OK to finish up and generate the toolpath. Let's use section view to take a closer look at the motion. As we can see, the tool maintains a 50% contact point for as long as possible, then slowly tilts the tool in to clean up material in the corners at the floor. Generating this accelerated finishing path through multi-axis pocketing has automated some of the more difficult choices a programmer usually has to make to get clean motion. This significantly reduces the overall time to toolpath this pocket.